guards, PennDOT controlled roadways or intersections, isn't that correct?
There were portions of it relative to West Pleasant Grove Road, but a lot did address PennDOT roadways.
So specifically, 202, 926, that intersection, that's a PennDOT controlled roadway and intersection, correct?
That is the intersection of PennDOT roads that is also adjacent to the property being developed.
Correct. How about the intersection of 926 and South New Street? Is that also a PennDOT intersection?
That is an intersection of two state roads, yes.
Okay, and the proposed access, wherever it may be, along 926, whether it's aligned with Broadwood or whether it's staggered, that would also be a PennDOT intersection, correct?
That would be an access to a PennDOT roadway, yes.
Okay, and how about traffic signal design and engineering? Is that also controlled by PennDOT?
That area is joint jurisdiction. Traffic signals are currently owned and maintained by the municipality. However, PennDOT has review and approval authority for permitting.
Okay, so PennDOT issues that permit?
PennDOT issues the permit, but the township owns the signal there.
Do you know who would own, if there's a signal warranted and constructed at the access along 926, do you know who would own that signal?
Specifically, no. It would either be West Town or Thornbury.
Could it be a combination of both? Have you seen that?
Yes.
In your testimony, you stated that the proposed condition of the use plan doesn't comply with a couple of zoning ordinance requirements. And if I'm correct, you stated one, it doesn't comply with the comp plan because you don't believe the connector road complies with the comp plan. Is that correct?
Correct.
And then the other was dealing with traffic hazard. Is your testimony that the proposed condition use plan creates a traffic hazard?
The zoning ordinance requires that the use will not result in or substantially add to a significant traffic hazard or significant traffic congestion. I would offer that this does not comply with that.
And what was the basis for that opinion again?
Impacts or the non-ability to use the 202 access during peak periods and contributing to the need for turn lanes at certain locations.
Okay, and who would be the jurisdictional, strike that, who would have jurisdictional authority over the design of the turn lanes that you specified?
PennDOT.
Okay. With respect to the Route 202 access, is that shown on the growth management plan for this property?
It is.
So how do you reconcile requiring that to be removed if the project is proposed, or sorry, is required to comply with the growth management plan?
I would defer to legal counsel to address the specifics of how that works.
So you are arguing that it shouldn't comply with the growth management plan?
A situation where legal compliance there may be in conflict with other sections of the ordinance.
So would that, or could that also be true then with the proposed connector road that is shown on the growth management plan as you testified to? If there's a conflict, it might not be warranted for the project?
I'm not aware of a conflict in the ordinance or that section.
It wasn't my question. If there was a conflict for the connector road, based upon your testimony with respect to the Route 202 access, could that also be removed from the plan?
Objection. It's calling for a legal conclusion.
He just testified that the Route 202 access could be removed from the plan if there's a conflict.
Yeah, I agree. I'm going to overrule that. And Mr. Federico, if you can answer that.
And so if there's a conflict with the connector road, could it be removed from the plan?
I would expect so.
One of your bases for stating why there's a traffic hazard at the proposed 202 access was the potential for increased accidents. Is that correct?
Yes.
Did you do any analysis at that location? Did you review any accident data? with respect to accidents at the proposed location in the existing condition?
I was reviewing the material provided in the applicant's traffic study.
Did that have any accident data on Route 202 at the proposed 202 access?
It did discuss accidents along that section of 202.
Did it have any specific data with respect to where the location of the proposed 202 access is to be constructed? And what does that indicate to support your opinion?
The majority of mid-block crashes along US 202 were rear-end incidents. 10 of the rear-end incidents occurred along southbound US 202, which is likely associated to the congestion experienced at the signalized intersection of 202 and 126.
And is that further south than the proposed access to the development on 202?
I did not specify.
Okay, so you don't have any specific data at that location?
I did not review any specific data.
Okay. If the proposed access to 202 was permitted by PennDOT, what configuration would it likely be in?
I would expect that only right turns in and right turns out would be permitted.
Do you know if PennDOT would require acceleration and deceleration lanes in connection with that access?
I would expect a deceleration lane. I don't know about an acceleration lane.
Would an acceleration lane help mitigate or prevent your concern that accidents could occur at that opening or intersection?
During peak periods when traffic is queued all the way to 926, no, I don't expect an acceleration lane to help.
Hold on, sorry, Mr. Clark. Just get a little closer to the mic there. The board's having a little bit of difficulty hearing you. I apologize.
Would you like me to repeat the question?
During the peak periods, I don't expect that an acceleration lane will help.
Hold on, I think we're going to get some technical assistance.
Better?
How about during non-peak hours when it's not completely congested? Would an acceleration lane help mitigate your concern for accidents along 202 coming from the right out?
My concern is more with vehicles approaching the site along southbound 202, not exiting the site.
Isn't there currently a right out from West Pleasant Grove onto southbound 202?
There is, yes.
Are you aware of any accidents that have occurred at that location or any propensity to have accidents at that location?
I don't recall.
I believe there was some testimony, and I just want to make sure I understood it correctly, with respect to the Route 202 and 926 improvements. Is it your testimony that all of the improvements would have to be constructed in order for the applicant to mitigate its impact, or just the ones that have been specified in the applicant's traffic studies? Because I believe that the PennDOT project involves multiple improvements near that intersection.
The improvements that I'm aware that are required for mitigation are the eastbound lane and the southbound right turn lane.
I believe Mr. Gill asked you some questions regarding the existing levels of service at the 926-202 intersection and then the levels of service post-development, is that correct?
Yes.
And your testimony was that existing it's a level of service F and then post-development with the improvements it's still a level of service F, is that correct?
Yes.
Notwithstanding that it's the same level of service letter grade, do the improvements actually improve the level of service at the intersection?
The improvements will reduce the overall delay at the intersection.
Would you consider that an improvement?
That would be an improvement.
But it's still the same letter grade?
It is still a level of service F.
Understood. Turning to the Planning Commission's conditions of approval, Exhibit B-21, I think you testified that there were two review letters. Let me see if I can. Talking about item number five, or condition number five. I think you answered that was it. There's a December 26, 2016, and a February 6, 2017 letter. Isn't there one other, an April 3rd, 2017 letter? There's three review letters that you issued, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Because the Planning Commission only references two. So there's three, correct? Right? Okay. And then with respect to conditions number six and seven, you had opined that the proposed connection on A6 is insufficient to satisfy what you consider to be the required connector road. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. What is the design of the connector road as you see it? What's its proposed right of way?
As a collector road, I don't recall what the specific required right of way is.
50 feet, somewhere in that range? Larger, smaller?
I don't recall specifically.
You're familiar with the township's subdivision land development ordinance?
Yes.
And the roadway standards, correct?
Yes, I don't have them with me though.
So. Okay. So you can't say offhand?
No, I wouldn't. Yeah.
Is it true that your concept of a connector road design is specifically designed to handle traffic not coming from the proposed development?
I'm sorry, could you repeat that please?
Sure. Is it true that your concept or design of a connector road, collector road in this case, is specifically designed to handle traffic not coming from this proposed development?
No, I would not agree with that.
Is the road specifically designed to handle traffic congestion on Route 202?
No.
What is the purpose of the road?
My understanding of the road is to provide a community connection for this development or the development of this property and the adjacent properties, to provide those residents along the western side of the township and the adjacent township a means to make local trips without accessing 202.
Local trips from where to where?
Between neighborhoods and up to the school.
Is that then dependent on the further connection north of West Pleasant Grove?
To access the school, it would be, yes.
Without that connection, does the collector connector road on this property serve a purpose?
I would think it does, yes.
Would that purpose be any different than traveling north and south on South New Street if there is no connection to the school?
I think there would be additional purpose to promote the interconnectivity and cohesiveness of the neighborhood, yes.
Which neighborhoods?
This proposed neighborhood, the Broadwood neighborhood, Arborville.
With the proposed roadway network on Exhibit A6, would this neighborhood have the same access to West Pleasant Grove and 926 that your proposed road would provide?
I don't believe so.
Why not?
The number of separate roadway links and required turns make it less desirable to serve that function.
Is your proposed roadway being a straight roadway result in higher speeds of vehicles?
I don't believe I ever proposed a straight roadway.
What kind of roadway have you proposed then?
I'm suggesting that there should be a connector designed to collector standards that connects from 926 to West Pleasant Grove Road.
In what dimension?
28-foot wide pavement.
Mr. Allen, just want to give you a heads up. We're at a 5-minute notice. I don't know if you can finish in that time period or if you want to continue at the next hearing.
I can't finish, but can I finish my 5 minutes?
Absolutely. I just wanted to give you the heads up on where we were.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Sure.
In your concept of the connector road, where would it intersect with 926?
Opposite Broadwood.
Would that then increase the amount of traffic that would then go through Broadwood?
I would expect that, yes, some traffic from this neighborhood would travel through Broadwood, yes.
Have you quantified that?
No, I have not.
As the township?
I don't believe so.
But this has been part of the township's growth management plan for a long time, isn't that correct?
Yes, it has.
So no analysis has been done on the impacts that the township is proposing with respect to this connector road?
Which impacts are you referring to?
Impacts to the surrounding neighborhoods.
I'm not aware of that type of analysis. Okay.
You testified with respect to the construction of a signalization, if it's warranted, at that intersection of 926 Bridlewood and driveway or connector road, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And you stated that money would need to be placed into escrow because sometimes it gets missed. Did I recite that correctly?
That's the gist of it. That's one of the
how does something like that get missed in your experience?
When PennDOT establishes the escrow, they look at the traffic signal as being owned by the municipality, so they may not collect escrow for it. Similarly, the municipality may look at the traffic signal and feel that since PennDOT was responsible for the permitting, they would have collected escrow for it.
So are you saying that potentially it's just a miscommunication?
Potentially.
Okay, so if the applicant were to include that in the overall financial security for a project, would that resolve your concern about it being missed?
Yes.
Okay. Just wondering, which is not, it doesn't have to be a separate escrow. With respect respect to condition number 12 in the planning commission's letter, exhibit B21, we're dealing with the improvements of the cartway of West Pleasant Grove Road. It refers to two sections in there, comply with section 149.903.82 for width and 149-910.D for paving. Are those sections from the subdivision and land development ordinance in the township?
Yes.
So wouldn't that be handled that land development anyway?
Objection, that calls for a legal conclusion.
He's the engineer. I'm asking him a question. He's familiar with the subdivision and land development process.
Understood. We're overruled and ask that. If that wouldn't be answered, please. And we're down to our last minute.
Okay. I'm pressured here.
I'm sorry. Was I asked to answer that?
Yes, I think you overruled the objection.
Correct.
So would that be something ordinarily handled at land development anyway?
It would be addressed at land development, but the applicant would have the opportunity to request a waiver from that requirement.
Township doesn't have to grant the waiver, correct?
No.
Okay. Am I done, Pat?
Yeah, if you don't mind, Mr. Engineer, how about we leave it there and come back?
I didn't hear a bell.
Sure. Trust me, it went off. We are at 10 o'clock, so we're going to stand in recess. We're going to continue the hearing this evening until Tuesday, August 29th. The hearing will be at 6 o'clock. It will be back here at Ruston in the auditorium. Mr. Federico, I'm hoping you're still available on August 29th.
I gotta go get my phone, it's charging over there.
Okay, Mr. Federico will be back to finish his testimony.